Hello, friends. Hope you're having a wonderful day, and we're back with some updates for you. So let's start. SpaceX has recently installed a new booster for its Falcon rockets at their SpaceX's rocket development and test facility in McGregor, Texas. Looking at the pictures available on the internet, it can be identified as a Falcon Heavy side booster. At least the logos and hardware exterior suggest the same. The new booster, B-1064, arrived at the development facility, having previously flown interstate from a non-Block 5 Falcon 9 booster. Having boosters tested with weird setup at McGregor facility is not something new, and it's quite obvious some special checks are to be performed before using the same for the next mission. Falcon 9 cores usually have the Falcon 9 logo with a US flag below the white inner stage with a SpaceX inscription, whereas the side booster displays SpaceX lettering at the bottom section. The booster spotted has no American flag or Falcon 9 logo on it, but there is a SpaceX logo on one side. As Falcon Heavy will utilize center core in the next mission for better performance, the hardware is necessary only for the side boosters. There's attachment points visible on the side booster for landing legs and grid fins as well. Before the 28th of February 2021, USSF-44 mission is scheduled to launch, where SpaceX will be delivering classified payload for the US military to geostationary orbit. The center core will be fully utilized as part of this mission, and SpaceX plans to recover only the side boosters. They'll attempt to land those on SpaceX's two autonomous spaceport drone ships in the Atlantic Ocean. If we take a look at the previous recovery attempts by SpaceX, amongst the three Falcon Heavy flights till date, the side boosters returned to landing zones 1 and 2 at Cape Canaveral, whereas the center core attempted to land on a drone ship downrange. Only one of the three center core landing attempts was successful, with core B-1055 landing on Of Course I Still Love You after the Arabsat 6A mission. SpaceX currently have only two active Falcon Heavy stages in the SpaceX fleet, and those are B-1052 and B-1053. These side boosters were used to launch both Arabsat 6A and STP-2. There's no plan in the future to use these boosters for the USS F-44 mission. If SpaceX becomes successful to recover all the boosters in the next mission, then SpaceX's fleet of Falcon Heavy stages to 6 side boosters and a single center core, enabling the company to support non-defensive customers requiring Falcon Heavy support. After the third military mission, USSF 67, Falcon Heavy will also support NASA's Artemis program. Via SAT-3 commercial communication satellite and the Psyche asteroid mission for NASA are included in this manifest. It's most likely to be selected to launch the initial phase of NASA's Lunar Gateway as well. Under the Gateway Logistics Services (GLS) program, the Dragon XL spacecraft, which used to deliver cargo to the Gateway, will also fly at least 2 missions launched on Falcon Heavy. Apart from numerous other commercial launches, Falcon Heavy may also launch additional national security missions under NSSL Phase 2. For the rest of 2020 and starting 2021, the Falcon 9 manifest will keep featuring a mix of new and reused boosters. The B-106 at the Kennedy Space Center is waiting for the first operational launch of Crew Dragon, the Crew 1 mission, which may be the last Crew Dragon mission using a new booster, because as per plan, B-1061 will be reused on the Crew 2 mission in 2021. The Crew 1 mission launch will take place no earlier than October 23rd. The Crew 2 mission will be conducted using a reused Dragon spacecraft, which supported the Demo 2 test flight. All the Crew Dragon missions we discussed so far are approved by NASA to use reused first stages and Dragon capsules. In upcoming GPS-2 SVO-4 national security mission, B-1062 will be used for the first time after the next Starlink mission using B-1058.3, which is scheduled to take place no earlier than September 27th, and GPS-3 SVO-4 will launch no earlier than September 29th. Using reused booster, SpaceX will continue to launch Starlink missions and cater some external customers until October's end. B-1063 will be used for the first time to launch NASA's Sentinel-6 spacecraft, and it'll be SpaceX's first launch from Vandenberg Air Force Base in California since June 2019, which is scheduled no earlier than November 10th. Later this year, two more launches are planned: the first Sun Synchronous Orbit launch for SpaceX's rideshare program, and the second launch to utilize the newly reopened Polar Launch Corridor from Florida. SpaceX reusability strategy and the growing fleet of boosters earned several contracts recently, such as Masten Mission 1, a robotic moon landing for NASA's Commercial Lunar Payload Services (CLPS) program for Masten Space Systems, contract for SES and Intelsat Galaxy satellites, which we already discussed in our previous video in detail. Okay, now let's see what Jeff Bezos is planning. As per the latest report, Blue Origin is planning to develop commercial space stations, expecting NASA to be the first customer. On September 18th, they posted a job opening for Orbital Habitat Formulation Lead at its headquarters in Seattle, Washington. That new recruit will be leading the company's development of commercial space stations in low Earth orbit as a new product line. As per Blue Origin's posting, "To develop Blue Origin's vision of billions of people living and working in space, humanity will require places for them to live and work, space destination systems in which value-creating economic activity can occur. LEO habitable stations, learning from but going beyond the ISS, are a first step." The new recruit will not only be leading the technical and business aspects of commercial space station development, but also look after the prospective customers and partners, as the job posting says. "Partnering with business development professionals, you will develop a detailed understanding of NASA, other government and commercial needs, and guide the iterative development of product strategy. You will be accountable for capturing external and internal sponsorship funding to establish viable LEO destination systems in the 2020s. It emphasizes NASA as the potential customer, as it says, "Tap your extensive NASA network to shape and accelerate the acquisition strategy for LEO destination systems." In its LEO commercialization approach, introduced earlier this year, NASA stated it would look forward to improving both industrial modules on the ISS as nicely as free flyer space stations working independently on the ISS. In January, NASA chose Axiom Space Inc., a new player in the space race, to get entry to an ISS port, which the organization will use for a series of industrial modules that it will launch starting in 2024. However, NASA paused a separate solicitation for assisting a free flyer station. At a session of the ISS Research and Development Conference, August 27th, corporate officers stated that they had been nonetheless interested in pursuing that solicitation, but did now not provide a timetable for doing so, which may give an explanation for the language in the Blue Origin job description: "To structure and speed up the acquisition approach for LEO destination systems." Phil McAllister, director of commercial spaceflight programs at NASA, said at conference, "I can't promise any specific timelines associated with that, but we are definitely working on the free flyer and intend to release a solicitation soon on that once we get our strategy all agreed to internally." Let's now discuss that new player in the space race that we just mentioned. Axiom Space Inc. They're a development aerospace startup company headquartered in Houston, Texas. Michael Suffredini, who previously, from 2005 to 2015, worked as NASA's International Space Station (ISS) program manager, along with Kam Ghaffarian, founded the company in 2016. The company has a majority of NASA ex-employees, including former NASA Administrator Charles Bolden, working right now. The leadership team also includes world-class, specialized expertise in commercial utilization of microgravity, on-orbit operations, astronaut training, space financing, engineering, space system architecture, design and development, space medicine, marketing, and law, the company states. Axiom wants to deliver its plan once NASA changes their focus from the ISS program to the lunar base operations. The company aims to build a low Earth orbit space station and offer future space flights that will fly regular civilians to give them an experience in microgravity and amazing views of Earth. While making access to low Earth orbit global during the remainder of ISS's lifetime, Axiom is constructing the future platform that will serve as humanity's permanently growing home, scientific and industrial complex in low Earth orbit, the cornerstone of human activity in space, the company states on their website, axiomspace.com. As per Space Shuttle Almanac's report, Tom Cruise and Lyman are all set to travel to the International Space Station in the Axiom Space Crew Dragon capsule in October 2021. Courtesy goes to Elon Musk's SpaceX. There's space for one other person on the flight, where they can accommodate another cast member. In May of this year, the film was first announced, and NASA Administrator Jim Bridenstine tweeted, saying that he's excited to work with the Hollywood star. We've covered this news in detail a few days back. Michael Lopez Alegria will be in charge of the flight. He has a glorious career as a commander in NASA. He spent a total of 257 days in space and did 10 spacewalks during his missions. In March 2020, he was retired from NASA. Now with Axiom Space Program, once again, the former commander will head to orbit. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comments section. This will help us to improve.